Sao rung rồi kia?
Cái con đường này, Scenic Road á.
À,
con đường này
sao biết?
Nó lạnh, nó nói như vậy.
That we ride about 2 hours, we don't see any car. Now we see the car. Now we see the town. Good. Welcome to Karoro. Welcome to Karoro. Colorado, beautiful. Còn cái đường đó, như cái này mình đi em được đi này, à, này đẹp không?
Mà cũng hay. Cũng
hay chứ?
Là hay. Ừ. Mình tìm chỗ nào mình đi thật đặc.
Colorado. December 31st, 2019, the last day of the year, the wonderful years. We are here in Durango right now. We head to Bagosa, the hot spring, deepest hot spring in the world. To see the hot spring here.
It's the geothermal
hot spring. And after this, we go back to Mesa Verde. That Mesa Verde is the main attraction. UNESCO, we want to go. But we stop by, on the way there, we stop by Durango to sleep. But this morning we wake up, we discover here we have the deepest hot spring in the world. Busaga. We want to go to hot spring, but take about 1 hour to hot spring. After hot spring, we come back to the main place in Mesa Verde, where we want to go. Chimirap. Nam. Chimirap. Now we keep going to Bagosa Spring. The hot air balloon. Hot spring. Oh, we have to go to the hot spring. Why are you
Continue on Hot Springs Boulevard for half a mile.
Healing water, thấy không ạ?
Dạ,
tối
hôm
qua ngủ.
À, không biết.
Không biết
bởi
vậy.
Hot spring.
Không biết mà xa 70 đồng.
Chú 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 chú. Hot spring. Hot spring.
National Monument rồi đàng hoàng chứ, bộ dẫn nhau. Như cái chim mi rớt không?
nice. Entering the Misavadi Park. Oh, my name coin.
Misavadi National Park.
Yeah.
Này, nó lô cái nốt kia là tại vì nó không có cái nô cái cô quốc kinh. So that's why they don't open. À, có người clean mà không?
Biểu biểu chung là trên mai clip. Cũng
có một cái vòng cái gì mà thôi.
Dạ, 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 biểu chung chung. Entering the Misavadi Park. Misavadi Park.
Okay. Một cái nét đẹp của nó.
Beautiful. No stopping, no backing.
Stopping là có cái xe đậu xong nó tới liền cái kiểu này và hay ổ lắm. Place step by
nó giống giống như trong cái thôn của thôn đây, trong cái này không phải thôn người ở đây, thôn của
cái máy
cái phòng của em thôn của người mà
không lẽ tôi tìm ông bố nó bảo à? nó đâu có sophisticated cái như vậy.
Nếu có nhiều khi đâu, có nhiều nó sắp tới nó connect to đó. Giống như cái dự án MC đó, khi nào có dự án cáp xe đó, tiết hết đó, có xe xong Mỹ hay lắm trời. Smart lắm.
Trace cái
cao
của mình ở đâu?
Bị smart lắm. Thì phải. Việt Nam
thì smart hơn, mắn hơn. Đây nè, ba muốn thâu không? This is the highest elevation in the Mesa.
Đó.
Nè.
Oh, platform height in the Mesa.
360 degree panorama view nha.
Beautiful, so beautiful, yeah.
Còn một cái đằng kia nữa.
Cái gì đó?
Có không? Mình cũng lên xe hơi nhiều đó. 15 phút nữa.
Thế mà chỗ này hay.
Chỗ này đẹp hơn chỗ hôm trước.
Anh làm đi coi như tập thể dục luôn đi phải không?
Em tưởng tượng sao một cây này nó chết mà mùa đông ấy, mùa xuân nó ra lại sao nó sống lại được hay thiệt. Thế là nó ngấm cái nước này nè. Cái nước này nè.
Thì giống như
nước nó tan ra đó.
Không, tại vì nó bị cô động lại đó. Nghe chất bổ rồi kia, cô động lại không lấy trầm từ đâu. Cô hồi lấy trầm dữ lắm.
Ôi,
nào anh đi giữ nè, giữ cái túi nè.
Năm bao nhiêu nó bị cháy á mà. Nay tìm tôi từ nay.
Vậy thôi cái gì?
Vậy xuống
được rồi. Xuống con này. À, không rồi em chứ anh. Vậy thôi gì? Ôi đi đây, xuống đi. Được rồi. Đi, tao rồi.
Cái này nó không có cho.
Dùng solar để mà cái điện ngay.
Tôi đưa cuốn sách em đọc sơ sơ. Có đâu, đâu có được vô. Con house step house đâu có được vô con đường đó.
Well, if I see them. Mm.
Xếp hao là bác qua bên này rồi. Không được.
The Palace. À, Bali House. Đó, lấy đó là phải đặc biệt.
Cái này mình coi được.
Nè,
nếu mà mình muốn đi tour nè, nhưng mà chắc mùa đông không có tour đâu. Trong này thì có chim én, đúng rồi, chim én nó hay. Hay làm tổ giống như là mấy cái sườn núi ở Nha Trang ở gì đó ở ngoài
Phong Tàu, Vũng Tàu
chứ Vũng Tàu làm gì có.
Có trời ơi, nước đi đó
không?
Có người nuôi én
đâu, ba đi chứ mẹ không có đi.
Ừ, cái em nước anh đi đó nuôi én nó nuôi nha,
nuôi vậy hết hay rồi, nuôi vậy nó hết hay rồi, giống như gà mà anh nuôi trong trong
không phải
không ấy đúng không,
không phải.
Để nó tự nhiên chỗ nào xuống ta.
Giúp đây nhé.
Ôi, không cho đi rồi bác.
Ừ, không đi hả?
Mùa đông nó không cho xuống rồi.
Sao nói bạn nói clip à?
Không quắc over được.
Không biết.
Không được, không có vô được đâu.
Sao vậy?
Phải có park ranger nó dẫn bà đi mới được, xuống kia nó đóng cửa rồi.
Ồ, uống uống à?
Uống ha. Vậy thôi là đúng tới September phải đi trở lại.
Ồ, đẹp trời đẹp. Ồ, đẹp. With many window. Không. Nhưng mà cũng hay em. Nè, có đọc đọc tên trước nè.
How of many windows. À. Work hard to survive here. Cái vùng này giống như Việt Nam mình á. Pottery nữa, mấy cái pot nè.
The house is many window. When the Indian, they stay here. Make the house, this house and window here. Okay, go. And warehouse.
Nó ghê hơn. Tôi tưởng nó là sao tốt lắm, tốt đồ hãy đứng này. Thôi. Đâu có mau ừ á. Đâu có ẩm ướt gì đâu. Đi với chú gà.
Chú gà em lạc.
Big cow.
Mm.
Navajo Hope Canyon Overlook. Sun Tembo. Eh, no, no, je vais faire un... Sun Tembo. Em coi đó, mà coi phía này.
Ừ. Cái này coi được whole thing.
À.
Đúng rồi, hồi nãy mình đứng đẳng kìa, thấy không?
Kìa kìa, là đó, đó, ra clip plus á. Này, đứng chỗ đó đó.
Ừ. Hay là em với anh chụp tấm đây
nè. Ở chỗ này nãy nè.
Ừ. Không, hồi nãy mình đứng bên kia.
Nè đó, cái này chụp bên kia, nãy.
Ừ, không, nãy mình đứng đằng đó, đâu, có cái bục đằng đó không?
À.
Đứng đó mình nhìn có bên, cái này nhìn hay hơn, cái video này hay hơn.
Lip Palace. Look in, from north side. Newsroom.
As if clinging to another time. And so it must have seemed to the young Swedish explorer in the summer of 1891. Gustav Nordenskiöld was a scholar driven by curiosity, by scientific inquiry, in a west that was still wild, Nordenskjold came armed. But all of his shooting was with a vintage Kodak camera. He was fascinated by reports of recently discovered lost cities in the southwest. But the small cities of stone were never really lost. For centuries, they were known to wandering hunters who had encountered the tumbling stone walls. And neither were the cliff dwellings from a lost civilization. By the 1890s, Nordenskjold, an archaeologist, had convincing evidence that the descendants of Mesa Verde lived on, in the pueblos along the Rio Grande, and in the Hopi and Zuni villages to the south. The past homelands and migrations of Puebloan peoples were remembered in oral histories, traditions, and ceremonies. Mesa Verde was neither lost nor forgotten, just unknown to the new settlers. Mesa Verde rises abruptly from the Montezuma Valley of southwest Colorado. Faulted and pushed up by unseen geologic forces, the massive block of stone and earth slopes gently toward the southeast. Streams cut long valleys into the plateau, dissecting the cap rock of Cliff House Sandstone. During winter, the endless cycle of water freezing and thawing wedges apart fractures in the sandstone, helping to create alcoves and sheltering ledges. Mesa Verde is constantly changing. And yet the landscape of today is very similar to that encountered by the first inhabitants. They were hunters and gatherers who came to this high plateau following game between 3,000 and 5,000 years ago. These nomadic peoples left little more than scattered stone tools and charcoal from their campfires in the archaeological record. For archaeologists, mysteries surround this high green tableland, Mesa Verde in Spanish. Like drifting clouds that obscure our vision, researchers may never get a perfectly clear image of the earliest inhabitants. Not until about 450 AD does the picture of the past improve. And then they appear, seemingly out of nowhere, the Baskin. Early explorers were impressed by their finely woven baskets. But these unknown people had left no evidence of pottery. The basket makers were hunters and gatherers, but they were also farmers, cultivating corn and squash. They lived in pit houses dug into the earth. Supported by beams, the pit house walls were made of jacal, woven branches covered with a mud plaster. The earliest pit houses clustered in small villages at the base of cliffs, on the mesa tops, and under protected alcoves such as here at Step House. As crops became more important to the basket makers, pit house villages were built and expanded on the mesa tops, closer to the fields. Between 450 and 750 AD, the basket makers learned to make pottery, and it changed their lives. As did another remarkable invention, the bow and arrow. Up to this time, meat consisted mostly of small game called rabbit snares, and kills made with an atlapo or spear thrower. Beans became a cultivated crop, and turkeys were domesticated, their feathers being woven into blankets. And then, around 750 AD, came one of the greatest changes of all. They left the pit houses of their ancestors and began building mesa top apartment houses of poles and mud plaster. Later, shaped and pecked stones would replace the crude wood and plaster walls. Their small apartment buildings grew in size. Mm-hmm. Today they are known by the Spanish word for villages, pueblos. Despite great distances in the southwest, many pueblos were linked by trade. With no horses or beasts of burden, all travel was by foot. Sandals were made of woven cordage or fibers from desert yucca plants. Mm. And sandals would carry valuable trade items to Mesa Verde for hundreds of miles away. Though remote and isolated, the Mesa Verde region was linked by trade. Copper bells smelted in Mexico made their way to the nearby Montezuma Valley. Cotton grown in Arizona was woven on upright looms into fine cloth. Locally, dog hair was made into sashes. Turquoise from New Mexico was fashioned into pendants and necklaces and inlaid into pottery. Shells from the Pacific Ocean, the Gulf of California, and even the Gulf of Mexico were traded to the Southwest. Ideas traveled, as well as trade items. In building construction, T-shaped doorways became common across much of the Puebloan heartland. Pottery was both imported and exported. Intricate geometric patterns became widespread designs. Mesa Verde was only a small part of a great phenomenon spreading across the Southwest, the ancestral Puebloan culture. In only a short while, the early Puebloan farmers had advanced to building cities, true cities. It began sometime after the year 900, not quite 100 miles to the southeast in the bleak desert surrounding Chaco Canyon. Huge apartment buildings of hundreds of rooms reached skyward up to 4 or 5 stories in height. After the year 1125, Chaco's importance waned. A severe drought may have forced the exodus, but whatever the reason, archaeologists believe the cultural center of the Puebloans drifted northwest to the well-watered highlands of the Montezuma Valley and Mesa Verde. By the year 1200, by any assessment, southwest Colorado was booming. With well over 30,000 inhabitants, more people lived here then than now. They spread across the land and clustered into several large cities in the Montezuma Valley, west of Mesa Verde. Some of the cities had populations rivaling all of the settlements of Mesa Verde combined. Like city lights of today, the glow of fires may have brightened the night sky, especially during ceremonial times. The influence of the ancestral Puebloans had spread across much of the high desert and as far west as present-day Las Vegas, Nevada. Back then, nothing made Mesa Verde special. It may have been no more than a rural outpost of a rapidly advancing people. But today, Mesa Verde is very special because of its cultural significance and its remarkable preservation. The small stone villages of Mesa Verde serve as our best window into the world of the ancestral Pueblos. Over 4,000 archaeological sites have been recorded at Mesa Verde National Park. The highest concentration of sites are found on 2 separate mesas, Weatherill Mesa and Chaitin Mesa. Separated from each other by deep canyons, each mesa was home to its own communities. Chaitin Mesa was one of the most important centers. At first, relatively few Puebloans lived in cliff dwellings. They lived on the mesa tops in pit house villages and small pueblos. By 1100 AD, they began construction of Farview House. party was possibly two or even three stories high. Today, evidence of 40 rooms remain on the ground floor level. The Puebloans never really abandoned their ancestral pit house homes. Instead, the pits were dug deeper into the ground and evolved into both functional and ceremonial rooms. In the Hopi language, they are known as kivas, meaning room underneath, social and religious centers. Five kivas are found at Farview House. Kivas were apparently very important to Mesa Verdean society. The usual floor plan was round, oftentimes with a key-shaped niche. Entrance was by ladder from a small hole in the roof. Benches ringed the keep, separated by stone columns supporting a cribbing of beams for the ceiling. Walls were plastered and often painted and embellished with designs. Kivas were well engineered. Fresh air was drawn to the underground room by a ventilator shaft. A deflector of stone or hachal spread the air evenly through the room. Holes in the floor secured upright rooms, which were fastened to both the floor and the tiered ceiling.
Okay, yeah.
Like modern Pueblo society.
This is the midpoint, the world famous four corner between Arizona, Utah, Colorado, and New Mexico. We arrive here, but the door is closed because the now is 4:40. But they close.
They close at 4:50.
4:50, so 1 hour late. Now, like, so not okay, not okay. Welcome to Arizona. Now we have to go Mexico, New Mexico. Now Arizona. That's an Arizona flag right there. Today is the first of the year, January 1st, 2018. We just leave Navajo country in the middle of state of New Jersey, and we head to New Mexico, and we go to Chaco Reservation, Chaco Cultural Monument. We took about 1.5 hour to go. Last night we went there about 40 miles away from the Chaco, but we could not find the hotel, so we had to return to this town here.
Farmington,
inside the Navajo country. That belonged to Indian, American Indian, originated from Indian town years ago. They live here 100% in Indian, live in this region. They call Navajo Reservation. So they had their own rule, local rule, and but if violate criminal, they had to rescue by state, like another American, regular American. So, but they also had special assistance from the government.
Turn right onto County Road 5500.
But not the always everybody assist that. Yet the own people. Yet the own people get assist from the government. But the people here got relaxing people like Mexican people. So they look nice and quiet.
Next right onto County Road 5500.
So I had to Chaco Park right now.
Continue on County Road 5500 for 7 miles.
In here, they don't have the low local tax something. So I stay in hotel here. No without the tax, but I travel in all the hotel outside the reservation. I think about 10% tax. UNESCO's eye in Navajo country inside state of New Mexico, USA. Rio informed us they lay the park closed because the employee Thanksgiving, Christmas and New Year days. But we hear already, even the rough road, 13 mile rough road like this, and we still come in because we want to see the UNESCO site. Let's see here. UNESCO site of the native American, not the Indian. They live in the Navajo Nation. Some area has no running water, only two well in entire nation. And before morning, they have some time there to walk to the well to get the water for the family to use daily basis. So that's hard in this nation inside of United States of America in 2018. Still a society like this inside America. In a bad memory.
Cái nhà tha hồ này mà thấy ông trong này nó làm mấy cái bột, mấy cái gì đó là nó từ đây nè.
We on Vietnam Veteran Highway. Or Highway 371. 371. Highway 371, they call Vietnam Veteran Highway. Vietnam Veteran Highway. We are on the Vietnam Veteran Highway. The freeway legally is 371.
Caesar.